In today's Innovation in Medicine, we're talking about a proactive and mindful approach to chronic pain management. And I'm here today with Dr. Atchison. And Doctor, I think a good place to start is talking about what this approach entails.
It's using a lot of different tools for people to try and help themselves gain control of their pain, have physical therapy, occupational therapy, clinical psychology, relaxation, biofeedback therapists. And we combine the tools that they have to help people.
So how do the psychological and relaxation components actually have an effect on the physical pain?
Looking at what's called functional MRIs of the brain, we know that chronic pain actually causes atrophy of some parts of the brain. There are certain areas that don't connect to each other and talk like they used to. Ultimately, what we feel in pain is what makes it to the brain. So if we can change the brain, then the idea is, can we go back and change how their chronic pain is either progressing or being perceived?
Why is this such an important innovation in medicine?
The idea becomes, before you take your pill, you need to do this stretch, this relaxation, this breathing technique, or what we think is working for them, and see if you get a response. And then remarkably, when they feel the response, they don't feel the need to take the pills. Their ability to take some of those tools home and start to use them is really the key to what we would call self-management for pain. So they feel like they can control it rather than having to rely on a doctor or a pill or something else to help with their pain.
That control is something Brad Waldman knows a lot about. He's struggled with pain for years that slowly got worse.
My hands and my feet were getting numb. Slowly but surely. I felt electrical shocks in my extremities all the time.
After visiting multiple doctors, he was diagnosed with cervical stenosis.
Cervical stenosis, that's when the canal is narrowing in around the spinal cord.
Basically, my vertebrae were growing inward and crushing my spinal cord.
Brad had surgery to relieve the pressure, but the damage that had been done left him with ongoing pain. That meant medication to help him manage.
I didn't want to be on medication all the time. It was making me dizzy. I had cognitive problems.
That desire for control brought him to the Shirley Ryan Ability Lab program.
It made a lot of sense to understand the problem first, learn about how to correct it, learn about how to manage it. Well, they concentrated heavily on my arms. Through training, you learn to adjust your body posture.
I think that the important part is that we have a tool and techniques that help people who haven't responded to anything else.
Brad learned how to respond to his pain and keep it in check.
But I've learned to manage it, and I've learned not to tense my muscles up. And if I think it's going to be something severe, I'll generally start putting myself into a meditation state. And as you relax and get into that state, your tension diminishes, almost to the point of zero. It's amazing.
Those tools helped Brad slowly get back to where he wasn't always focused on his pain.
I'm doing very well. I'm actually off all the medication I was once on. I'm managing the pain just by my daily activities and the use of my mind, essentially. It really attacks the entire problem, top to bottom. Was a life-changing event for me.